He just took a bowl, put a handle on it, stuffed it with horsehair and covered it with, guess what? Ginza flies, goose skin. So he finally made use of his thing. I don't know why he used goose skin, but it must have worked really well, because Bibles that are still in existence are just beautiful. So this is the way he would roll the ink onto the ink ball, by turning and rocking it and rolling it onto the ink ball. So hence we know that Gutenberg was the first rock and roller. Now he used two ink balls because that would speed up the process of inking. So he has to rub the ink balls together so that they're both exactly the same. We've got to get the ink perfectly smooth over the whole surface of the ink ball, the same thickness, and evenly distributed. And so rolling up the balls did take a little practice and a little skill, and also a little time to get it just right. What do you think? Does that look pretty smooth?
That's very nice.
These are Gutenberg lollipops. How about a lick? Nobody likes licorice.
Well, ever since that first
Okay. Time. Now we have to come straight down with the ink balls to get the ink just on the tops of those letters. If we went like that, it'd smear off onto the edges, wouldn't fill the letters in. So coming straight down, we begin to apply the ink to the tops of those letters. The person that did this became known as the beater. And of course it took a little practice and skill to do this, because we have to get a little ink on every letter, and we can't get too much on a letter because that would just fill it in. Okay, I think we're about ready to go.
We printed
What's the next?
How many? 120.
Don't interrupt me, please. Okay, now I forgot where I was at.
You were asking us the next
I'm
step.
I'm inking the type. Okay. What's the next thing he has to have to print on?
Paper.
Well, something to print on. He printed about 180 copies of that first Bible, 40 of them on animal skin, and the rest of them he was able to print on paper. Paper had just been invented in China and had come to Europe through Italy. Now the paper was being made for the scribes, and so it was hard and slick, didn't work very well with Gutenberg's oil-based ink. So he had to soften the paper by dampening it. Now he knew that if he just laid a sheet on like this and rolled it under there, he couldn't make and roll it into. Let's see. He's got to figure out how to print on the other side and line it up exactly. Mm-hmm. And so here's the answer to that problem, the timpan and the frisket. I'll open it up here. This is called the timpan. It's just leather over a frame that provides a place for us to put our paper on. These little points called duckbills position it up and down. And then the mark left and right here. Now watch this, these pins poke through the paper. And when he prints on the other side, he puts the paper back on through those same holes. And that gives him perfect alignment between the front and the back. It's still basically the same system that's used on printing presses even today, pin register. Now the frisket comes down to hold the paper against the timpan. It's cut out there where we're going to print. It also allows us to lift that paper back up off that sticky type without smearing it or tearing it, because it's damp. So now we're ready to fold the bed of the press under the platen. The next thing that happens is to pull the handle, which turns the screw and lowers the platen and presses the paper against the inky type. The person that did this was called a very exotic name, the puller. So we're going to have some of you guys and gals be pullers. We're going to make two impressions. So let's have, why don't you come and do our first impression? Two hands up there and pull it towards you.
As hard as you can.
Trying to make a good impression.
Don't break it. When President Monson was here, he pulled that thing, and I said, don't break it. Bob brought the house down. He really pulled it, though. He moved the press a little bit.
Okay, now notice the size of the platen is really quite small. Because the bigger the platen is, the more power it takes to get sufficient impression. So we just printed the one page, so we've got to roll it out and get the other page. Now, we'd like to have some of the gals do it. How about...
Go for it, Sabrina. I'll film for you.
Okay. Take a picture. We're going to pause while we do it. Pull it as hard as you can.
Okay. Hard. Come on. Don't push, make a good impression.
Both on top.
That's what Gutenberg did.
Well, that sounds pretty good.
It's hard.
Did it?
Yeah. How'd you like to do that all day long?
You'd have some arm muscles.
All right. Now we're going to roll it out. Now listen quiet, man. You can hear the frisket lift that paper.
This is called
off that sticky
top. Press kiss.
Oh boy.
We did pretty good.
Wow.
We did a pretty good inking job and a pretty good pulling job.